wonderful day to watch football. Maybe quite hot for the players, but one clearance from Jason Steele.
That's Dennis Garmash wearing 9 for Ukraine. Scored 2 late goals that got in the semi-final against Serbia. One for France, it was very, very tricky. And I think Chippy was just a little bit nervous in that game. First 45 minutes, I thought his second 45 minutes, he was a lot better.
One of these will win the under-19s for the very first time. All the work over the last year all comes down to this. Well, it's a chance and it's a goal for Ukraine inside 5 minutes. Tucked away by Garmash.
Peace. And it did look to me like Garmash had got away from his marker, but I think his marker probably thought, well, is that far?
Jason Steele couldn't get anywhere near it, the England captain and goalkeeper. Partsvania being closely watched by Partsvania. It's been impressive, the Ukrainian centre-half. In the England corner, not quite as successful as Ukraine's first of the game.
Yeah, both centre-halves have been pretty rock-solid. Partsvania away in 3 there.
It's Trippier again. Header away from Partsvania. Pushed off that time by Kokishko. Now Rebelka. Partsvania. Garmash. England have it back though. This is Matic. Did well to keep it in, but there was nobody there. Not sure where he was playing that.
I think when the ball moves over to that side of the pitch, Welbeck has got to expect the clears to come up that side of the pitch. He was actually... Ukraine have responded well to England's onslaught that they had after conceding that early goal.
Partsvania finding Kokishko. Delfuneza. Under pressure from Kushnerov. He's done well though, Delfuneza. Shook off the challenge of Kushnerov. But trying to mount up the England corners. Ukraine have only had one, but... Ball over the top, the flag has stayed down, but it's belatedly gone up against Delfuneza. Had one chalked off in the semi-final against France offside, and oh, that's touch and go. Partsvania took an almighty gamble there.
Very, very close indeed. City week in, week out.
Trippier's ball in, and Partsvania taking no chances with Welbeck in attendance. Another England corner.
You know, he'll be used to play. He will be used to playing in front of a crowd. Leicester City.
This is Bennett.
No, it still looks like Delfinezu's wide on this near side.
Well played by Shakov. This is Partsvania. Delfinezo is down, so Partsvania kicks it into touch. Kept his place in the side. The player to miss out was Dmytro Yeremenko. He's been playing.
Attack the goalkeeper. Again, keep the goalkeeper under pressure.
Right in front by a goal to nil. Garmash, the goal scorer, with the touch back to Partsvania. Now Kritsov. Header away that time by Walker, up towards Welbeck. Partsvania wins the header again. Trippier happy to take the throw. You can see Brian Eastick there out on the edge of the technical area. I'm sure he's pleased with the way England have gone about the opening half an hour. Just a brilliant finish by Garmash from the corner. And this has started off pretty well too. That Ukrainian goal and England's response. Here's a chance now for England, maybe. Partsvania just stepping in. And Lansbury holds his head in his hands because just for a second there was an opening.
Trippy run from Lansbury. Again, we can see them time and time again. Drink water, Lansbury, Lansbury, drink water. Making runs from that midfield, central midfield zone. Lansbury unlucky, couldn't quite get the touch right, but 100% commitment.
Yeah, he's very much the heartbeat of this Ukraine midfield and works well in tandem with Rebelka. There's a solid centre that Ukraine have to this side. He's got the look, Petrov, of some of the great players that turns away from taking a lead into the break. Partsvania's header.
That doesn't look 10, does it?
Here it comes, 2-0! Near it. It is England 0, Ukraine 2. And what a wonderful goal from Dmytro Korkishko. Nothing in the game at all, but it's Ukraine who lead 2-0 again. Partsvania. Trippier. It's looking like more final heartache at the moment for this particular bunch of players.
A bit slow coming off his line there, Levchenko. He just had Partsvania sweating a little bit as Gosling was trying to nick in.
Crane, same 11 that started the game, is still out there. Brian Eastick has played his cards early.
Fritzoff and Partsvania have been very solid for Ukraine. Oh.
It's too high that time for Delfunezo. All the way through again to Levchenko.
Yeah, good defensive play again. Centre half going for the ball. One dropping off, seeing it through to his goalkeeper.
Ukraine have scored 4 goals against England in this competition. 3 of them from set pieces.
Of course, Kishko scored there was just sublime. We've been raving about it. It was an English play.
5 minutes into each half. A bad ball over the top. Partsvania across though to win the header. Levchenko gets there and saves the corner.
Different class, Partsvania. 2 or 3 times we've seen him get right round level with the opposition players. They'll lose the way. They've got to keep
the killer blow. Garmash. Partsvania. It's over the wall and straight at Levchenko. I made a bit of a meal of it. And it was too close to...
They've enticed players into to making challenges on them and...
Matic. Searching ball again, has too much on it for Delfunezo.
From Garmash. Well, that's allowed Walker to have the ball and try to rob him with the last minute with a sliding tackle and play the ball into the box to his teammate, and it very nearly came off.
And just to put this in some perspective, and it is all over. Ukraine are the under-19 European champions. Underage side, if you like, has lost in a, all the under-21s losing to Germany, and now England losing to Ukraine.
It's been a good tournament, from start to finish. It's been run very smoothly. There we see the number 3 for Ukraine. Partsvania, very solid, very reliable defender. I think they've had some big performances from players at different times in this tournament.
And the two against France in the semi-finals.
Been on side of the pitch in the dugout and more or less just let them.
Did his best up and down that left side, but England didn't have too much joy anywhere.
He was well protected by his back four. Looked a little bit nervous in the first half, but never really got put under.
We'll never ever forget. Big contrast for the English players, of course. There is Partsvania, who was impeccable in the centre of their defence. One of the reasons that they managed to keep 3 clean sheets from 5 matches, and that was the difference really, I suppose. England did well in the tournament, but ultimately if you don't keep clean sheets, you're not going to come away with the trophy. Ukraine are the under-19 UEFA European champions. They're absolutely beaming and